Defense Updates has reached more than 150,000 subscribers. We're genuinely thankful to our viewers. You keep us going.
Follow us on social media. Support us on Patreon. All links in description below. The Admiral Gorshkov, lead ship of the new Project 22350 series of frigates, will be commissioned in August, with Admiral-series vessels expected to become the backbone of the Russian Navy's ocean-going presence over the next decades. The Admiral Gorshkov began its construction at Russia's Severnaya Verf shipyard in St. Petersburg all the way back in 2006. At that time, it was the first large surface vessel to begin construction since the collapse of the Soviet Union, an event which temporarily threw Russian shipbuilders and the military industry as a whole into disarray. Project 22350 gave Russian shipbuilders the challenging task of developing a fundamentally new frigate fitted with the latest 21st century technologies, many of them never used by the Navy before. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why Russian Admiral Gorshkov class frigates can even take out much bigger destroyers of rivals.
Number 5.
Project 22350 is the successor of the Krivik class. Unlike their Soviet-era predecessors, the new ships are designed to perform multiple roles. Military observers Andrei Kotz and Viktor Murakovsky outline what capabilities the advanced vessels will offer. As RIA Novosti military observer Andrei Kotz recalled, the Admiral Gorshkov was designed with universality in mind, with the capability to combat surface ships and submarines with equal effectiveness, attack land-based targets with high-precision weapons, resist aircraft of the probable enemy, carry out reconnaissance by taking advantage of its low visibility characteristics, and much more. Russian Navy Command remains confident about the promising vessels and their capabilities. In 2016, Defense Minister Sergei Shoigu confirmed that the Russian Navy would commission six Project 22350 frigates by 2025. Before that, the Navy said it hoped to receive over a dozen of the Admiral series vessels in the near future for service in the Arctic, the Atlantic, and the Mediterranean. Speaking to RIA Novosti, Viktor Murakovsky, editor-in-chief of Arsenal of the Fatherland magazine, said that the Admiral Gorshkov is presently the most technologically sophisticated, modern, and impregnable surface ship in Russia's arsenal. The ship effectively serves as a research institute, the observer noted. Since 2006, the Admiral Gorshkov has seen the testing of virtually all of the Navy's latest technologies, from electronic equipment to anti-aircraft missile systems and artillery mounts.
Number 4.
Admiral Gorshkov has a length of 135 meters and has a displacement of 5,400 tons when fully loaded. It's powered by two 10D49 cruise diesel engines. The Admiral Gorshkov class are relatively fast ships, traveling up to 30 knots per hour, with a range of close to 4,850 nautical miles, or 8,980 kilometers, at 14 knots per hour cruising speed. In autonomous navigation, the vessel's 180 to 210 sailors and officers can remain at sea for about a month before needing to resupply. It has a FERC 4 5P27 main radar for detection, tracking, and targeting of air and surface target. The main radar is supplemented by Polymint 5P20K four-faced active-phased array search, tracking, and guidance management radar. Moonlit 34K1 surface search radar is present to detect surface combatants. Zarya M and Vinyetka towed array sonar are available to identify submarines. The well-equipped sensors provide the vessel with a 360-degree view of its surrounding.
Number 3.
To date, four Project 22350 ships, including the Admiral Gorshkov, the Admiral Kazatanov, the Admiral Golikovko, and the Admiral Isakov, are under different stages of development. The first of the three have been launched and are undergoing trials, fitting out or the final stages of construction work, and all are expected to be delivered before 2020. At least four more ships have been ordered. The Russian Navy has set a requirement for 20 to 30 such ships.
Number 2.
Admiral Gorshkov class vessels are designed to be nimble, relatively compact in size, with stealth characteristics aimed at making them hard to target. The important aspect is that these have the ability to punch above their weight. The Admiral Gorshkov's main strike power is provided by its 16 Vertical Launch System Caliber, or ONIKS, cruise missile-equipped cell launchers, with air defense assured via 32 Polymet Redut seaborne missile complex cells. Close quarter defense consists of 2 Palash close-in support guns. ASW defense is covered by 4 Packet NK torpedo tubes. Finally, a 130mm A-192M naval gun firing 45 rounds per minute provides shore bombardment support. The ship's weapon systems will be controlled by a new digital onboard information and control system, complemented by cutting-edge radio-electronic systems to keep tabs on approaching surface ships and submarines. It also has deck space for 1 Ka-27 series helicopter.
Number 1.
The lethal offensive assets are the ONIKS, or the KALIBR cruise missiles. The P-800 ONIKS is a Russian supersonic anti-ship cruise missile developed by NPO Mashinostroyanaya. The missiles can carry nuclear or conventional warheads and can travel at a distance of up to 185 miles with the ability to skim along less than 30 feet above the ocean surface at speeds of Mach 2.6. The missile includes an inertial, active-passive radar seeker head, which makes the missile essentially autonomous once it's launched. It even has onboard EW countermeasures to resist jamming. KALIBR missile has many variants. 3M54T is the anti-shipping variant deployed by the Russian Navy in a surface ship with a VLS launch system. It has thrust vectoring booster, enabling it to have a range of 440 to 660 kilometers. It's a sea skimmer with a supersonic terminal speed of Mach 2.9 and a flight altitude of just 4.6 meters at its final stage. A simultaneous attack with 3 to 4 either P-800 ONIKS or 3M54T caliber missiles could, in all probability, penetrate the anti-missile defense systems of the world's best destroyers, including those of the American Arleigh Burke-class destroyer, as well as those of aircraft carriers like Nimitz-class. These relatively cost-effective vessels, if built in good numbers, could provide Russia with an effective surface fleet.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.